talking this morning with Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Golly, it's good to see you again. It's been a while since Rundown.
Yeah, the last time we met was a couple years ago.
And that was your last film, is that correct?
That was the last one we talked about, I think. No, but I've done a couple.
But you did the Buford Pusser movie.
Exactly.
That's right. Yeah. I remember now. Right. Yeah. This movie, The Gridiron Gang.
I could tell you liked it.
I did. I mean, didn't think I was going in. Thought it was just going to be the standard type of rah-rah movie, but you did it. I mean, y'all made something special out of it.
Thank you.
My first question to you, though, Dwayne. When you make a movie like this that is so intense and has such a positive message and so involved, how does it affect you? Does it affect you? Is it done incrementally and it doesn't affect you, or does it?
No, that's a good question. I think it affects me on a lot of levels. Number one, you know, playing a guy who's still alive, playing a guy who not only works in a prison, but oversees five prisons for kids, you know, and trying to get that empathy and that passion, that intensity that he had. I didn't want to imitate him as much as I wanted just to capture that type of emotion from him.
Yeah.
The essence of this guy, Sean Porter, a real guy. It affects me that way because you see, you know, here's a guy who's not in it for celebrity. He doesn't care about any of that. All he cares about is changing lives. That's why it was an honor. It's an honor for me to play this guy. It was great for me to get this type of material. And you realize, you know, it opened my eyes to this world. I was one of those kids, Jackie. I've been arrested multiple times.
I read that. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
You could have been right in that same scene.
And look, I'll be honest with you. I could have easily been locked up. I could have been one of these kids. I had somebody in my life who cared enough about me to say, you're going to stop screwing up and you're going to make something of yourself. And come hell or high water, I'm going to make sure that it happens. And I know through football, what football did for me, teaching me the value of commitment and hard work and failure, how to deal with that failure, how to be gracious with my successes as well. So all those values, learning that I was able to take with me throughout the rest of my life, that's how it affected me. I know how it affected these kids. And when you get a guy like this who only cares about changing lives and making a difference, that's when you realize just how great it is to have human beings out there like that, who don't do it for money, don't do it for celebrity. They just do it because they care.
Well, you know, talking about the essence, because I really felt like you captured the essence of Sean in this film, and especially when you see the documentary that runs during the credits,
sure.
You know, boy, that's so impressive. It really is. I mean, nobody leave until the very final thing, so you can see that. But somebody asked me, I'm going to, you know, go talk to The Rock, and they said, oh, yeah, that's that wrestler who acts. I think after this movie, it's going to be that actor who sometimes wrestled, because this is a defining film for you, I think.
I appreciate that. And
did you get that feeling when you were doing it?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and for me, there have been moments in my acting career that were defining. I think the very first movie, Scorpion King, I came out, that was defining. That was a good opportunity for me to finally break through. And then specifically on Be Cool, you know, you play a character like Be Cool, share the screen with Travolta and Vince Vaughn and guys that. And that was defining in terms of, here's all comedy scripts coming your way. But with a movie like this that has this much heart, that has this much character, and that has this much honesty, that was a big deal for us, making sure if we're going to shoot this world, we're going to be honest.
Oh, it's not a happy ever after film.
No.
Not at all.
No, not at all. Well, you know, the thing about it is the great positive message is that you can make a difference and every kid deserves a second shot. And at the same time, look, these kids, they go to the championship game. Do they win? Well, you're going to have to watch the movie.
That's right. Don't give anything away.
No, not at all. And does this guy save lives? You bet he does. And to this day, as sure as I speak to you today, he's out there busting his butt every day to try and change these kids' lives.
Well, this is such a good movie. What are you going to follow it up with?
I appreciate that, man. I got a great movie I'm really excited about. It's a big family comedy with Disney, so it's safe for all ages, which I'm excited about. I could take my 5-year-old daughter to go see it. It's called The Game Plan. And following in the line of my love for football and my love for sports, I play an NFL quarterback. We are Super Bowl bound, buddy, MVP. I drive that Mercedes McLaren. I sing Elvis. I got my Elvis guitar, and all of a sudden I get that knock on the door. I open the door. It's that little 7-year-old girl who calls me daddy.
Well, in other words, you're going to go from one extreme to the other. I mean, you're on your range. Look, thanks so much for taking the time to talk with us, and I wish you all the luck with The Gridiron Gang.
Thank you so much, Jackie. I'm glad you enjoyed it, man.
Okay.
Thank you.